I'll say good afternoon to everyone, and thank you for joining this session. This is the showcase presentation, and our presenters today will be Shifra Maazar, Yulia Gurenk, and Ella Ben Emanuel. Your microphones have been muted, so I don't have to ask you to mute them. You will not be able to use them, but if you have comments or questions, you can write them in the chat, and I will keep track of them. The session is 30 minutes long. Each presenter has 10 minutes, and then we will have 10 minutes for questions at the end. So I now hand over the mic to Shifra.
Hi, everyone. I'm so excited to be here. So my name is Shifra Maazari, and I'm an English teacher at Amit Amichai in Rehovot, specializing at remedial teaching. I'm also an English counselor in the Central District. I'm also an NLP practitioner. In addition to my teaching in regular classes, I also teach special education students. And I strongly believe in the saying, people with special needs reveal what is special in us. Today, I would like to share with you a special method that I created, which I found makes learning English simpler, which I've called Wheels of English. I've spent a long time developing this method, and I found it effective for teaching strong, weak, and weak students and both online and offline lessons. So, what are Wheels of English? Why have I developed these methods? And how can we use them? I hope to answer all these questions in my presentation today. So, Wheels of English is a tutorial kit for students. It has 8 cards. Here, I don't have everything here. I hope I can show you here. I don't know if you can see it, but this is the kit, 8 cards, which are two-sided. The kit includes all the basic grammar a student needs to speak and to write in English. For a long time, I've been looking for a simple way to teach English without using grammar books. I have found that our students, they know grammar as math formulas, and they cannot apply it for speaking and writing. And therefore I decided to create this kit, and you can see different colors, and I divided into different parts of speech. And now even I want to thank Ronak Varyal for helping me with the colors and with all the structure. She gave me a lot of advice. So why have I created this kit? This slide will show you. I have learned more from my students than I have learned from my teachers. The mistakes shown in this slide are the main reason why I have created this new method of teaching grammar. The year was 2001. We were 4 couples who went on a shlichut to USA. Our job was to teach and to give lessons in the community. These sentences are examples of some of the mistakes my husband and his friend made. And as an English teacher, I had to give them a quick course to improve the language. And then I saw, like many of them said, have many parks in the city. They confuse with there are and have, because in Hebrew, both of them are yesh. I was a dog last year, and one of them said this instead of I had a dog, because was and had, hayah. So whatever they had in the brain, they pick it up. So these mistakes are the main reason for creating the kit. Observing my husband giving lessons in English that time, I noticed that most Israelis, they make mistakes because they don't distinguish between 4 types of sentences in all the 3 tenses, present, past, and future. Therefore, I divided each tense to be used in these 4 groups, which are. So I divided it like, there are sentences that describe a noun, and there are sentences that describe one's surrounding. There are sentences that show ownership, and there are sentences that have verbs and action. And I see that all the sentences, like the same structure in the 3 tenses. I tell my student, when you want to talk, when you want to say or write a sentence or a paragraph about a certain topic, choose and follow the correct wheel. Choose the correct tense and then the correct sentence. once they understand this structure, they find it very simple to use. I've gotten a lot of positive feedback from my student, and they said, finally, we have a useful tool to help us succeed in module C. So now, how do I use these methods in my online and regular lesson? Before I start sharing my idea, I would like to explain to you that very important point. When I prepare a lesson, and also you, when you prepare a lesson, you should remember to use the 3V model, as I call it, for a good lesson. The first V stands for values. All the time set goals for success, set goals for your lesson plan, believe in your students, love them. Also, the second V stands for VAC. What is VAC? It's from the NLP area. VAC stands for visual, auditory, and kinesthetic. Remember, 40% of our students are visual. They learn through seeing. 20% of our students are auditory. They learn from hearing. And 40% are kinesthetic. They learn from doing, touching, and moving. It is therefore very important to cater to all learning style during lessons to enable the most efficient learning to take place. And the third V is various tool, and this is my tool, Wheels of English. So how do I use Wheels of English in my lesson? So first of all, I start with the speaking. I put or upload the three circles on the screen or on the board in the classroom. I draw them, and also my students, they have this kit.
Shifra, you have 2 minutes. Sorry, excuse me.
What?
2 minutes.
No. Okay, so they start with speaking, and they have to speak with, and I encourage them to use empowering sentences, and with the three tenses, I am, I was, I will be brave, there are, there will, there were, there will be good things in my life, I have had and will have a dream, I believe, I believed, and I will believe in myself. And then we go to reading, and we see how also we have the structure and all the paragraphs that I teach them, and I upload the text, and I show them, see, have, and translate it, see the verbs here, see, M is VR, and the same thing in the past simple. I show them the different kinds of the four groups. Was and were, there was and there were, the verbs, and this way we learn the grammar, not as formula, as part of the text. And then the most important part is writing, and this is my goal, how they write. I tell them, when you get a subject to write about, please choose the right wheel and think about the four sentences that should be in the text. And this way they write an opening sentence, and I can give you an example quickly. Here it's about present simple. And for example, write about a special person in your life. So, or they start, a special person in my life is, and then they start to describe him. There is and there are, it's a problem, and then what he has and his action. He does many things, or we do many things. The same structure for the past, the same idea, they go according to the wheel, and also for the future. And here, during online lessons, I use the Padlet, and they wrote in the public. I hope I have time to show you quickly.
No, your 10 minutes are up.
Yes, so just one. Okay, so this is the Padlet, and let's go to the end. Okay, so I would like to thank all of you for listening, and just to finish with one very important sentence, as John Dewey said, wait, if we teach today's student as we taught yesterday's, we rob them of tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Shifra. Our next speaker, our next presenter is Yulia Gurenko. And Yulia, the mic is yours.
Green?
Yes, I want to do
this. Yes, share your presentation.
Okay. Okay, good afternoon. My name is Yulia Gurenk. I work as a teacher of English in elementary school. I am also an English counselor, and I have my enterprise and my initiative, my project. This is a story about dreams. Before I talk about Angloland itself, I want to tell you a couple of words of how it was born. The story started 5 years ago. Throughout all my career for all 20 years, I used technology, I used games on computers. I had great collection of discs with games for practicing teaching, learning English. Whenever I saw something, I bought it and I used it. With the development of technology about 8 years ago, slowly by slowly, all my discs just stopped working. Wow, great disaster, really. With every new Windows, some of the discs stopped working. I started looking for things in the internet. 5, 6, 7, 8 years ago, it was not like it is now. There was no quizzes, word roll, and other nice things we are using. There was only Quizlet, which wasn't 100% what I wanted to. Exactly at that time, I graduated from Oranim, finished my MED. I was looking for professional development. I had a lot of ideas, and once I came to Pisganet Sratelit, where Iris Saar told me, come here, I have a great project for you. And there, in a project called Maitzim Behinuch, Angloland was born. In a year, they sent me to a national program called Ed Start. Both programs are for developing initiatives from the field. So what's Angloland? It's an app to help pupils learn and practice vocabulary in a pleasant and easy way. What's important for me as a teacher, I choose the content and I see all the progress. When, how many times, for how long, how many points the pupils got, I see all the information. It's very easy to enter because we have all the Ministry of Education approvals, permissions. So you just register with the regular Ministry of Education password, which is especially relevant for elementary school pupils. To log in is also a big problem for them. This is the way teacher's screen look like. You see it's on computer. It can be also used on a phone. To make a new lesson, you just click the button, give a name to your lesson. It's very easy to build a lesson. You just type in a word, and even without finishing it, you already see all the words starting with the same letter combination. At the moment, we only have band one. Angloland at the moment works with band one only. So just choose the words that you want. You can publish and unpublish your lessons the way it works in Moodle. This is what the pupils see. When entering, pupils see all the lessons that you published. When entering a lesson, pupil can play four games. The games are the same all the time, but the content is different. The games are matching picture to the word, word to the picture, a regular memory game, and matching game with many options. Pupils can also find a list of the words for the same lesson if they forgot or what they're playing with. For sure, pupils can see their points for every game separately or for all the lesson. And in the leaderboard, we can see competition between the classes. This way, you can encourage them to play even more, saying, for example, 5B, 4B is just next to you, only 12 pupils played. Please come and play. Nice design. Now to statistics. This is the most important part for me as a teacher. I can make a lot of conclusions with the statistics. At the moment, we only have four games. Maximum points per game is 1,000. Meaning the pupils just play and enjoy and that's it. For example, a pupil got 600 points. Okay, she got 600 points. But as a teacher, I understand 600 out of 1,000, it's 60. Or 835 out of 1,000. For me, it's a grade. I see that this is 83. Okay, it's out of 1,000, not out of 100. We also have bonus games when pupils finished and got 1,000 points. There is a bonus game. Just the same game, but it should be done quickly. Maximum points is 1,200. So four games, 1,200 per games, 4,800 is maximum pupil can get for a lesson. This is the way statistics look like. I can choose according to the lesson, according to the class. I want to show you how I analyze the statistics. For example, as I told you, 4,800 is maximum per lesson. If I see that the pupil has 4800, perfect. He practiced a lot, he knows the words, great. If I see, for example, another pupil having less, I can analyze it, I can see points per game, and I can make a lot of conclusions. For example, this specific girl played once and got 160 points. Wow, she doesn't know words at all. She played another game 9 times. It's far from perfect, but now she got 66. So my conclusion is, if she plays more, for sure she will succeed. And I see that she didn't play other games at all. So I can tell her, please practice more. You see, when you practice, you succeed. For example, let's see another boy, 2400 points, which is not a lot. But I see that he played once, one game, and got maximum bonus points. He played another game, maximum bonus points. Wow, he knows the words very well. So I don't care that he didn't play a lot. I will not be angry with him that he didn't play a lot of times. I see that he knows all the words. How can I use AngularLand? For sure we can use it during the lesson with the computers, with phones, after the lesson. We can give it as a homework. You can tell pupils, play 10 times or play at least till you get to 800 points. You can give it instead of work pages, instead of workbooks. For sure, vocabulary review at the end of the unit or once a month. We can have class competitions. As preparation for tests, for example, you can say, play at least 10 times with all the sets we had in this unit. Or the pupils who get 4,000 points per lesson will get 5 bonus points for their tests. At the moment, this year we had a pilot. More than 20 teachers used AngularLand, and we have great feedback from the field. For sure, the next year we go on working. If anybody is interested, there is a link. You can leave your contact information, and I'll be in touch with you at the beginning of September. That's it. I finished. 9 minutes.
Perfect. Perfect. Thank you very much, Yulia. I do see the questions in. Sorry, my lights just went out, and I see the questions in the text in the chat box. When we're finished, when all three speakers have finished, then I will address the speakers. There were only a few questions. Our final presenter is Ella Ben Emanuel. Ella, please share your screen.
Oh, sorry, I have to stop sharing.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I am looking for my, where is it? Just a minute, getting my PowerPoint. Here we go. Okay, start at the beginning. Okay, my name is Ella Ben Emanuel. I'm a PLC leader for high school teachers in the Jerusalem area. I'm talking about PLC's role in teacher empowerment and my I just wanted to start with a little story. I'll try and say it in like 20 seconds. But
Ella, you're maybe you need to get closer to your router. We can't hear you. You're very, very broken up.
Okay, let me try. Is this better? Is it better without my earphones? Yes.
Fine now. For now, it's fine.
Okay. Yes. All right. So when I was a kid, we went to a safari park in England, and we went to check out the zebras. And it was my brother and my father decided to take a picture of the zebras. And there was a nice, very pretty looking zebra. Yes. Everything good?
No. Something is very weird with your internet connection. Right now, it's okay, but when you speak, it's not. Is there anyone else
working
using?
Fine when we did. Is don't hold anyone... this against me.
No,
don't
no,
take
no,
it
no.
from my 10 minutes.
No, but we need to do this quick. Is there anyone else in the house who's using the internet?
No.
Not television, not a cell phone, nothing.
No. Well, me and my phone. It's just me here. I'll go closer to the router.
If you can, yes, maybe it'll help.
Okay.
Right now we can listen. You sound
is the sound better
well.
Now?
Yeah, but it was better.
Now
as
it's fine.
Yeah,
now it's fine. Okay, great. Okay, so back to the story. Anyway, my father wanted to take a picture of my brother with the zebras, and he told him to get closer and closer to the zebras, and in the end, my brother got kicked by a zebra, which is a very, like, today, and he had actually a hoof mark on his back. I wanted to talk about teachers and how kids can help.
Ella?
You still can't hear me.
Now I can hear me? If I may suggest, could you turn off the camera?
Yeah, sure. One second. I'm trying to...
You need to find the Zoom bar.
Yeah, I'm on the Zoom line bar.
It has a camera picture on it. That's what you need.
I've already got a strip here. One second.
Yeah. If you'll
here we go. Here we go. Okay. Right. Okay. Stop video. It says audio.
Not stop my, not the microphone, the video.
It says my speaker isn't working.
Now your speaker is working.
Yes? It's better?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Barry, by the way, your speaker isn't working, but we'll continue.
It is working or it isn't?
No. Ella, you can continue.
Okay, great. So, a teacher is a lone wolf by definition. It's a lonely profession. We have attitudes from the management that say that if the parents are complaining, it's not and we just... So, more emphasis put on administrative demand. Yes.
Once again, we can't hear you. I'm not sure what the problem is. You're closer to the router, right?
I'm close from here. I'm getting a message that my...
That your internet connection is weak?
She's also muted now, I think. Hang on.
Yeah,
she's muted now.
Okay. Can you hear? Same as system.
When you are speaking slowly, we hear you. I don't
know
why.
Maybe,
but
yeah.
As soon as you start to speak fast, then all of a sudden we can't hear you anymore.
Okay. All right. I will try and speak slowly, but it's hard because I've only got 10 minutes. Okay.
You've got less.
You have a lot less now, yeah.
Yes. So basically, we don't get the support that we need, and teachers could feel disempowered. They feel that they do not have the professional development they need. They feel that they're under pressure from above to try new things, but that this desire to try new things doesn't necessarily come from them and wanting to from within. It comes from without. And also we all have to deal with the different demands of disengaged students, of demanding parents, of management. I don't have to go into detail about all of this, but this leaves us feeling overwhelmed, and it doesn't make a difference if you've been in the field for a long time or a short time. And basically sometimes the success of the teacher in their school can be something to do with the luck of the draw rather than anything else. They don't know whether it's their professionalism or their pedagogy, or it's just the fact that they're in a good place with a good class. And also we have lack of access to role models and mentors. We often spend our day rushing from one thing to the next. We don't have to professionally. We
Ella?
Have people. Yes?
Slower.
We have people that we would like to see and watch in action, but we don't have time to observe them and learn from them. And in the internet itself, there's good stuff on the internet, there's stuff that is not so great. And it's very hard. We don't always have the tools to find things on the internet that we need at the right time. How does a PLC help? It's a professional learning community. It's not a professional learning course. Why? Because everything that we do within the PLC is focused on developing us as a community. The teachers come in as a community, and they are given topics by the leader, not the professor, not the lecturer. It's the PLC leader, and it develops them. They develop the tasks themselves. And by working as a unit, by working with other teachers in the field, they automatically feel like they're part of something, just like these pretty penguins. They feel like they're part of something and they feel less like a lone wolf. And they also feel the support of a community. When they act, learn and grow as a community, they lend each other mutual support. They feel that they have a safe space for raising concerns and problem solving. Yes, we often go in the classroom and we talk about problems we're having, but a lot of it is just us blowing off steam from one lesson to the next in the middle of the coffee break, or a teacher giving you tricks and tips, but you're not getting the lasting solutions that you need as a teacher to develop professionally in the field. And one the other thing about the PLC is that you have inspiration by observation. One very important part of the PLC is observation tasks, where teachers go in and they look at their peers. They watch their peers' classes just in order to learn from one another. It's not what we're used to, where we have the coordinator coming in or the mafmarit. This is people just, hey, I want to check out your lesson. Let's see what I can learn. This was interesting. Tell me more about what you were trying to do here. And a lot of the PLC, having taught PLC for 2 years, they told me that the most important aspect, the high point of their PLC, was walking into the classroom of a colleague and learning from them. And this is how they can find ways to improve themselves, by being inspired and by finding that internal motivation that they're often lacking, rather than feeling that pressure from above. And the role of a leader, as you see, the wolves in the pack, I'm one of the pack, you know, I'm the leader, but I'm not anyone different. I'm a role model, and the leader doesn't dominate or take charge. The sessions are very much participatory, and it shouldn't be any one particular person taking the podium. I'm not there to judge, and I'm there to encourage, moderate, and inspire. And one of the other things from a PLC is that you can gain that boldness that you're willing to experiment. Because as you experiment and try new things, you feel empowered. And this year we had the big coronavirus challenge, and we were introduced to a new technology. New technologies. Rachel, I'm off. Sorry, I can't talk. Basically, these teachers, thanks to the PLC and with the resources of one another, they were able to accomplish things they wouldn't have been able to do on their own during, and this really paid off during the coronavirus period, because we had just been learning about Google Classroom as we went into the closures. You have to know that success is infectious, okay?
And like 2 minutes, please.
Yes. When a group acts as a unit, and the success of one member is the success of everybody, and it gives them a feeling of empowerment, of can-do, and it's something that we're lacking as teachers. Takeaway number two, your colleagues are your best resources. Everybody can learn from one another. They can share from one another. They can share experiences, and they can really learn. And novice teachers have things to teach experienced teachers, and the other way around as well. And as you can see, we've got a lot of feedback that people said. One of them said, being part of a PLC this year encouraged me to break the boundaries that we had against using new technologies. Another one said they enjoyed the lesson, felt inspired to try new ways of teaching. Being part of a PLC community helped bring down the level of fear and getting used to online teaching. So the feedback was generally very good, and I really encourage you as much as you can to become part of a PLC, and it will change your attitude and how you look at teaching, and it will also give you the support and the wealth of your peers, because you are all your own best resources. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ella, your presentation was lovely. I'm sorry about the technical issues, but now I learned something new about Zoom. You have to talk slowly.
No, that's not it. That's
that wasn't
not
it.
No, it was because her microphone was the only one working. On some computers, it makes a problem.
Huh, okay.
I opened my microphone, and since then it was okay.
Okay, we have a couple of questions. One question for Shifra. Rania asked, when you feel that students can be independent and work without the wheels?
Okay, so it depends. Every person has a different personality and also a different memory. But the idea that the three wheels, they have the same structure, help them a lot. And I tell them to draw the same image in their brain or to draw it quickly before a test. They said it's very helpful. So it's better to have this than nothing. But of course, I push them to be independent.
Okay, thank you. And there was a question for Yulia also. Debbie Cohen asked whether the students need to sign in with a username and a password. Yulia?
Microphone. You're still, there you go. Pupils log in with the ministry password, just the way they log in to Galim and Ofik. At the beginning of the year, your Rakeze Tikshuv gives all the information to Galim and Ofik. And when you, as a teacher, is in the system, you don't know about all the process, because Rakeze Tikshuv usually does it for you. When you are in the system, all the pupils are together with you in the system. So if anyone is interested, you have to be in touch with me. I add you as a teacher. The students don't have to sign up. They just log in every time they enter.
Okay, any other questions? We can, I think, open up the microphones to questions if other people have questions. We have about 8 more minutes before we have to finish.
Okay. Anyone who wants to can open their mic.
Maybe we don't have any questions.
It's always a possibility.
Okay.
I have a question, Yulia. Well done, very good job. Yulia is my counselor. I saw that it works only on the receptive level. Am I right?
I have a lot of ideas. The idea is very big. I have much more games and much more things. But, budget. So at the moment, we have what is called MVP, minimal product that could work. And if I find budget, I have many more ideas.
Okay. Thank you.
Other questions?
I just have a comment. First of all, good job, Yulia. Thank you very much. And Ella, I loved your presentation. It was a shame that we couldn't hear you in the beginning, but I loved all the beautiful photos. They were amazing. And the connection between what you said and the pictures, well done.
I have to say that I found it, I wanted to find something that was kosher and there wasn't stealing any images. And I had all these ideas of Lego characters and all sorts of things. And actually in the end, the animals worked fine.
Yeah. You will use the Lego next summer.
Conference. Have to find some royalty-free Lego pictures. Yeah.
No, but the animals, great.
I have a question to Shifra. Hi, Shifra. My question is, in what way and how is your NLP experience implemented in the daily teaching?
Oh, I use it a lot in my classroom. During speaking, the beginning of every lesson, we say empowering sentences. And by these sentences, I practice all the grammar. They have to describe themselves. How do you feel today? I am happy. And I give them like a list of adjectives: brave, healthy, strong. There are many good things in my life. And we practice it. There are many good things. And you show maybe, and you see the slide. And there were many good things in my life. There will be. So they use the three tenses to say all the empowering sentences. And I teach special education students, and some of them they have autism. They see me in the hallway all the time. Shifra, I'm healthy. I was healthy and I will be healthy. And also all the time, I set goal for success. And we have like a contract at the beginning of the school, even with the high school students in group B, to write what are their goals, how do they want to achieve it, what are they going to do to achieve it. They have to set time, you know, it may be the smart, it's not a time and when to achieve, it helps them a lot.
Okay, and another question to you, Shifra, is how well can elementary students express their feelings, given the fact that their vocabulary is quite limited?
So you can give them a chart with vocabulary. Like I do, it's like brainstorm. You put all the adjectives, yeah, and all the time I add, there are a lot of songs with these adjectives. I'm able to, I have the courage, by the way, like I am brave, I have the courage. I put all the four kind of sentences with a lot of adjectives. I add every day, every lesson you can add more and more, and it's good.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions?
Yeah, do you insist on unmotivated children to express verbally their feelings?
No, if they don't want, it's okay. Mm-hmm. But when I see somebody, like when he says, I'm angry, or I said, it's okay, you can be angry, but now let's change it. Let's start talking positively. And you will see, you will change also the way of thinking. Also, I'm telling them, sometimes I'm tired, but okay, so now let's say it in a positive way, and you will change the way your brain thinks, and they start to believe in it. They believe in it, and yes, yeah. I don't get it.
Amazing, Shifra. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you, too.
Okay. Any other questions before I sum up?
Want to ask her a question about the interference of the first language and its effect on the second language. At the beginning, she said that her pupil made some mistakes, and her husband also, I heard, made some mistakes, and she wanted to correct them. How can we stop this? It's not an easy thing to do, because we, as second language learners, sometimes face this problem. What are your suggestions?
The question is for me. It's for Julia. Okay, good.
No, the question is for you, but
no, but you answer. Give them an answer.
Well, answer fast. We have 2 minutes.
Look, as language experts, we have to know and we have to make comparative analysis of our native language and the foreign language we are teaching. So before our pupils make those mistakes, for example, with have and there is, we already know they will make it, because this is a problem of Hebrew, as Shifra said. So before I start teaching it, even in the fourth grade, I have to make that comparison and division. If you start working on mistakes before they make mistakes, it makes it easier.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay,
thank you. I hope that this will help.
I'd like to thank the speakers, Shifra, Yulia, and Ella. Thank you very much. We are now going on a break from 4:00.